YouTube, and welcome to my playthrough of a new game I just received called Talisman. I purchased it on my Android, and I'm running it on my computer so I can record it using BlueStacks, which is kind of awesome for playing Android games on your computer. Anyways, let's get into it. Talisman is a board game. There's many expansions. I just have the base game. I've only started playing this. My first game was yesterday, so I'm going to be a newbie at this, I'm sure. But let's get started. We're going to click on the new game, and I've set the players to be random so that we can just get a random game, and I'll just click Start Game. All right, as you can see, we've got a board in front of me, and a board consists of this outer ring that goes all the way around, which is where me and my opponent are. You can see I'm a sorceress, and I'm against a minstrel. And the object of the game is to get into the center command of... If you click stuff, it usually shows you what the spaces do. I'll draw a spell first, I guess. Invisibility. Casters required. You may evade any creature or character until end of turn. Well, that's nice. That will help me in a battle. Anyways, if we click on stuff here, yes, it shows you what it is. So you want to get to this final spot called the Crown of Command. And once you're here, you cast spell after spell to reduce the life points of the opponent. When your life reaches zero, as long as you're at the Crown of Command, or when the other opponent's life reaches zero, you win the game. The area around the edge here is quite easy to go around. As you get into this inner edge, it's more difficult, and then this is even more difficult to get through, so you need to level up and grab stuff. Just really quickly, if I click Sorceress and I click on the icon, it shows me my abilities. I begin the game with one spell. That's the one I just drew when we started. When you attack another character, you may choose to make an attack psychic combat. If you do not do this, you may not do this when you are attacked by another character. Psychic combat and strength combat, there's two combat types. We'll get into that a little bit later. You may attempt to bejewel a character that you land on, allowing you to take one gold or object of your choice. So that's awesome. If you do, roll one die. You must roll a 6 to bejewel a good character, 5 or 6 on neutral, and 4, 5, or 6 for evil characters. So that lets me steal things, and I may take only one follower, except for maiden, unicorn, princess, and a character. So that's kind of crappy. I can only take one follower. But anyways, let's see what the minstrel does. The minstrel, my opponent, animals and dragons will not attack him, although he can choose to attack them. If you do not attack an animal, you may attempt to charm it. Rolling a 1 will charm it, and that makes him a follower, and it adds to his strength in the battle. So that is pretty awesome, and you can also take maiden and princess from any character you land on, so he can steal my followers, or my follower, because I can only have one. Anyways, we have a craft, a strength, a lives, a fate, and a gold. Strength is how much you're doing battle against your opponent and other creatures you come across of. And craft is also attacking your opponent as well as creatures that have a craft instead of a strength. You either attack with strength or craft. Anyways, lives is 4. When you lose your lives, you either respawn somewhere on the map without any stuff, or if someone's casting the spell to lose your health from the center of the game, you lose the game. Fate lets you reroll. This minstrel has a fate of 5, so he can choose to roll a dice and then use a fate up and then reroll. And gold is used to buy stuff, and he starts with 1 gold. So you can see that on my character here. I've got strength of 2, craft of 4, lives 4, fate 3, and 1 gold. Anyways, let's get started. We roll 1 dice. You can choose to move either way. You can go, I can go over to here, I can go over to here, and you see these are flashing as well. To get to these spaces, I would go 1, 2, 3, 4. I'd have to go through this this guy here. I'll zoom in on him. He's the sentinel. The sentinel has a strength of 9, which means my strength is only 2, so more than likely I will lose. So you wouldn't want to get into this outer ring until you build up strength. I'll zoom back out so you can see what's going on. We have a choice between landing at the chapel. Chapel, you land there. If you're evil, neutral, or good, stuff will happen. You can see that my card says that I am evil, which means if I click on the square, it tells me that I will lose 1 life. So that would be bad to go there. This one over here, the forest, roll 1 die and suffer the consequences. Let's go there because I don't want to lose a life, and we can possibly gain a craft. So we'll travel to the forest. All right, we're rolling a dice. You can see we rolled a 5. 5 means I'm safe. Nothing happens. That's just what I wanted. And I could choose to reroll using a fate, but I will just continue and let the computer play. And my turn. All right, his turn. Minstrel's thinking, rolling dice. Sometimes the computer plays not so bad. Sometimes it plays pretty stupidly. Okay, so it drew a hobgoblin. You can see there's a strength of 3. and it also drew an axe. And the reason it drew two is because this square says you to draw two cards. So he's fighting the hobgoblin. You can see that he took his strength of two, and he rolled a four to give him attack of six, and he won. And the axe is just an object which you picked up. Anyways, that was kind of a lot of information, but we'll just roll the dice. You'll get the hang of it as stuff goes, as time goes on. Okay, so I can choose to move to this woods, which would be draw one card, an adventure card, which is down here, or up here with the plains, which is also draw a card. So let's go up to the top. I'll grab a card there. It'll flip one open. Gold. Gain two gold. So my gain will go from one to three. I'll just click continue. It'll ask me if I want to take it. Of course I do. And you can see I've got three gold now. Enter in gold you use to buy stuff in the village, which is right over here. Or you can flip cards over and get merchants and all sorts of things. So they're rolling a dice. You can see they're stuck on, I'm just going to click on the eye here. They're in the tavern. They rolled a one, which means he gets drunk, collapses, and misses a turn. So I should get two turns. If he doesn't re-roll the dice, he didn't. Or he is. No, he didn't. That was me now. So I should get two turns. So I don't want to go to the tavern. Tavern, you can roll the dice and get any of these things. I think I'm going to travel to the woods because I want to get my adventure cards. You need lots of these before you can get to the middle. Potion of Strength. When you drink the Potion of Strength, it will increase strength by two until the end of turn. Once you have drunk it, place it in the discard pile. So if I do a low roll fighting a creature and I need to increase my strength, I would use that potion. So we'll take that. You only take three objects. You can see when I click on myself, I've got a potion. And I've got a spell here, which makes me invisible, so that's nice too. But you can only carry three objects. Spells are not objects. You can carry more than spells. Don't consider that as an end of my turn. I should get another turn now. Yeah, Minstrel missed the turn. I roll the dice. Three. So I can either go to this square here, which will draw an adventure one card, or I can pop over here and draw one card. Let's go that way. Let's go left. Draw an adventure card. Blizzard, an event. Winters come with invention for Blizzard and envelopes the land. For two rounds, all characters, no matter what region, will only move one space. Okay, so which means on his turn, he'll be able to go only one space, and same with me. Do I want to be able to go to the city? I can sell stuff. I can sell stuff. I can heal, or I can visit this enchantress, which I don't think I want to do, so I'm probably just going to head to the right. Ogre, monster of two. He has a strength of five, so he's fighting it. He's got a strength of three. And a modifier, well, thanks with three. So his seven versus ten. So he's losing this one. And he suffered a life, which will take him to three lives. All right, so my turn. I can only move one square, so I don't have an option to roll. I'll flip over an adventure card. Giant, strength of six. Not good. Okay, so this is where I want to use some stuff here. I can battle him. I maybe have that potion. You want to kill as many monsters as you can. Let's continue and see. I'll just encounter him and see what I can roll here. So a strength of two. I'll click on my guy and I'll maybe use my potion of strength. So we'll click it and use object. That should give me plus two to my strength. So I should have four now. So it's four versus six. I need a high roll here. Roll the dice. Six. That's perfect. That gives me ten as long as he doesn't roll a high number. That's nine. I beat him. 10 versus 9, I will continue, and I will claim that card. So you can see I've got the card here. Once you get creatures, you can trade them in for increasing your stats, which we'll get into in a little bit. And so you do want to kill and attack as many much stuff as you can. So that's the spot where you draw two adventure cards. An animal he's got to fight, and a follower. The animal is strength 1, so he's versus 2, plus any modifiers he has. He's rolling it. Oh, he's trying to charm it. Tried to charm it with his ability, and he didn't pick up that other card. Why? What's there? He didn't take the follower. Huh, interesting. Maybe she can't take followers. Let's check her ability really quick. No, it doesn't say that he can't, as far as I know. All right, well, I'm not sure why they didn't take that follower, but let's move along here. What's this card on the ground? That's that blizzard, so we don't need to worry about that. I will head over this way, and we will flip another card. A Wraith, a craft of five. So that means I use my craft to fight him. I've got a craft of four, so it'll be a close match. Let's see what happens. So my craft four plus my dice roll. Five, that's nine. That's not bad. And he rolls a three, which is eight, so I should beat him as well. Fabulous. And I will capture his card. So you can see that I've got his card now. I've got the two cards. Once you receive, I think, two or three of them, Then you can trade them in, and it'll give you that option over on the right-hand side of your screen. So he's moving over there, drawing a card, an angel. If you are a good alignment, gain one life. If you're evil, lose one life. No effect. So I think he's good. Yes, so he gained a life. Rolling dice, three. So I can go to either city. So here we can visit the Enchantress to roll. We can heal up my health, which I don't need to. Sell my stuff like that I don't need to. Tavern is kind of a gamble. You can win gold. You can get teleported to other spaces. Let's travel there. And we'll just do a roll and see what happens. One, that's not what I wanted. I missed a turn. I could re-roll the dice here, but it's pretty early on, and I want to keep my three fate to keep my re-roll. So we'll just continue, and I'll miss my turn. Minster will take two turns here. Six, where is he going to go? He can go grab these cards again. All right, so when you land on a space with cards, you got to play those cards out. So he tries to charm it again. He's rolling. He has to roll higher than a one to charm it. So he rolled a three, which means he's taken it. And he can use that one strength guy when he's fighting to increase his strength number. So charming is okay. It's a low creature to charm, but it is a benefit when he attacks. He still didn't pick up that follower. Oh, it's still his turn because I missed my turn. All right, he's moving off to a square, drawing a card. Bag of gold. So now he's at two gold. He's going to take that, obviously. Roll dice. I don't think gold counts as objects either. You can carry as much as you want. So I don't want to go to the forest here because then I have to roll. I'd rather just flip an adventure card. So let's travel over there. Flip an adventure card. Pool of life. That's awesome. These pools flop up. There's pools of strength and all kinds of stuff. And it adds four counters of life on this spot. And if I zoom in, you'll see here that it says three. That means I've used one. It increased my life total to five. Each time you land on that square, you can take one of those life totals, those little life chips, and increase your life. So he'll probably start coming up there and seeing what he can do. You can see here he's visiting the Mystic, rolled a four, he's becoming good. He already is good, so that really doesn't affect him, and it ends his turn. Now it's my turn, so I'm going to roll the dice. Two, it should zoom out for me so I can see what's going on. Yes, it does. I can visit the woods, which will draw a card. I don't want to go to the city, so I'm just going to go to the woods. In the early on, you want to flip over as many adventure cards as I've found as possible. So here's another Wraith, craft of five. I have a craft of four. Let's go for it. See if we can beat this guy as well. Roll the dice. One, that sucks. So let's see what he rolls. Six, I have no chance of beating him, so I'm not even going to use my reroll. I could reroll the dice, but the most I can get is four plus six is ten. I can't win, so I'm just going to continue. It's not horrible. You basically lose a life, so I'm dropping down to four again. There we are, end my turn. You gain life back, you gain life, so it's not a huge thing to lose. It's just that you want to win as many of them and then trade them in for more power. Oh, he's visiting the city again. Well, let's see what we click on that so we can see. So gambles and loses a gold. All right, good stuff. Two, so city or I can get the life again, so watch. So I'm going to go back to the pool of life, travel here, and grab another life. I'll go from four to five. And you can this little green little cone here will actually say two. If I zoom in now, it should say two. Yes, it does. So two more times, someone can land there and take the life. So if he rolls a four, he's going to for sure head that direction. But he didn't, so where's he going to go? Phantom haunts this space, and it grants a wish. And I think it grants it for evil characters. I'm going to read that card really quick. The first evil character can choose to increase their gold, strength, craft, life, fate, or gain a spell. So I definitely want to head over there and grab that space. So if I roll a one, I'm going to make my way over that direction because I want to hit that space. Draw a card. Dragon, strength seven. I'm toast. I'm going to use my invisibility potion, I think. So let's click on this. I will click my invisibility. Cast as required. You may evade a creature or character at the end of turn. I'm going to click it and cast it. And hopefully casting it at the right time. Casting spell. It's giving him an option to respond if he needs to. I'm going to continue. Uh-oh, I might have casted that at a wrong time here. Oh, I can evade. Okay, good. Evade. Continue. So it still leaves the card there. So next person that lands here has to fight this dragon again. So maybe once we're stronger, we can head back up there and attack. But we only have two strength, so chances of beating that dragon early on are quite high. So he's rolling at the Mystic. Six, gain a spell, so he'll draw a spell card, which we won't know what it is. He can just use it whenever, just like I just did. And I want to head down here again, so three. Well, I don't really want to hit this, but I will anyways because I want to get down into that thing. So let's get a see what we get here. 5. A wizard offers to teleport me any space in this region. Oz, your next move. Well, that's awesome because my next move, I'm going to go there and grab that guy. So that is good. I'm just going to read my ability again while he's playing just so I can see what I can do here. When I land on a character, I can steal his stuff. Got it. I can only take one follower. Got it. And I can choose to make an attack psychic in combat. So I probably want to increase my psychic amount, which is 4. Resume the game. Oh, my strength is quite low. Oh, he got a raft. So a raft is another way you can cross over this river. So he can pop over on his next turn. You see it's flashing any square I want. I want that one phantom. So I definitely want to go to this square here. Travel here. And encounter that guy. And I can choose. Let's go strength. Up to 3 on strength now. Perfect. All right, so he's using his raft. Okay, he's heading across the river, and across the river is some squares that you draw more than one card and some other stuff that's a little harder, but he got across without fighting that sentinel. So he's fighting a shadow, he easily beat that. So he'll gain that card and get to trade him in if he's got enough of them, which it looks like he doesn't, so it's my turn. 4. Either way, I think we'll probably be okay to travel here. Bag of gold. So that brings us up to 4 gold. So what I want to probably do now is land on this... take my object here. Is land on the village here, and then I can purchase the blacksmith and buy a shield or some armor or something else. A sword. And I can increase my strength further. So, he came back into the inner ring. It's kind of a waste to use his raft. A sorcerer will sell you spells. That's a good spot for me as well. For buying gold, trade gold for spells. So let's roll the dice. 5. Does that get me to the sorcerer? No, just passed. So I can drop down to this guy, this follower. I can exchange it for 3 gold. So I don't really want that guy. I can exchange it for 2 lives at the castles. And this down here, chapel. I am evil, which means I will lose 1 life. So I guess I want to travel here, and I'll just ignore. Oh, I guess I'll flip 1 card because it's a 2-card spot. Fountain of Wisdom. Oh, 4 craft points are found here. Fantastic. That'll give me an extra craft. I'll click encounter. Princess, I don't want to take it. I'm going to leave it, and I'll encounter the Fountain of Wisdom, and my craft will go up by 1. So that is awesome. That should have 3 spaces now. I zoomed in on the minstrel instead of me. Flipping over a card. Strength of 5 versus 2. So he needs a high roll here. He's got a modifier of 1. Oh, he's using his boar. So he should have a modifier of 2. So he's adding 4. Oh, he probably will get this unless ogre rolls a 6. No, he did not. So he'll take this ogre. I wonder if he'll have enough cards to cash in yet. Yep, trade trophy. So you can see he's going to trade an ogre and a hobgoblin. And he gains a strength of 1. And I'm going to zoom out here so I can see what's going on. And roll the dice. 4. Perfect. Right to the town. Let's just double check this just in case there's something awesome here. I can't remember what it was. That's the Wraith, so I don't want to do that. So I'm going to dismiss and click over here and travel. And we'll visit the blacksmith. I've got 4 gold, so let's continue on with the blacksmith. And I'll click continue. All right, so what can I get? An axe is great because you can use it to make a raft. Versus a sword. So I think I can buy the axe, so I think I will. I could buy more than 1 item. The only other item that takes 1 gold, I think, is a sword. And, oh, it's 2. And, so I think I'm just going to buy... The shields are okay. The armor is really good. If you lose a battle and roll a 4, 5, or 6, you don't lose health. But I think I'd like to increase my strength. And I also want to be able to build a raft in a forest. So let's purchase an axe. I guess I clicked on it. There we are. Purchase. 3 gold gone, and I gained the axe. So you can see I've got 3 plus my axe will take me to 4 when I'm in battle. End my turn. All right, minstrel, what are you going to do? Roll the dice. 5. Where's he going to head to? Enchantress. He's going to visit the Enchantress. Now you want him to turn to a toad. If you turn to a toad, he gains a spell, which is not good. I don't know if he can gain another spell. You can only get a certain number of spells based on what your craft is. So he's got 2 spells already. So he couldn't get any more, so that was kind of a waste. If you get turned into a toad, you become a toad for 3 rounds, and you can only move one square, and you can't pick up nothing. It's quite a bad thing. This is not a bad space for an evil character. It lets me replenish my fate, or I can pray and possibly gain a spell, gain a fate, or get ignored. The forest, that's not so good, so I think I'm going to go to the graveyard. And because I'm evil, I will click pray and roll my dice. I'm hoping for a 6 to gain a spell, or 1 to gain a fate. I got a 1, so nothing happens. So I could have re-rolled there. I guess that would have been a good idea. But then you still have to roll a high number, so I don't know how good that would be. 6, he'll go to the tavern. And a boatman offers to transfer him across. So he can ferry across to get to this square on his next round if he wants to. He'll probably go there. There's 2 cards here. What are those 2 cards? Oh, that was that one with the craft. Definitely want to go here with the Fountain of Wisdom. There's still 2 spots, or 3 on that one thing. So I'm definitely going to go to here and grab that chip. So we'll click encounter. I do not want to take the follower, but the Fountain of Wisdom. So you can see it now says 2, and I increased my craft to 6. So I'm getting pretty strong in craft, which is good. See, he's crossed the river there. Let's zoom out. He's rolling 2 dice. Oh, he rolled 2 because he rolls 2 and then does what this decides to do and what happened to him. You can click up here and it tells you what happened. Minstrel rolled 2 at the temple. Minstrel rolled 7 at the temple. He lost a fate and he gained a craft. So he ended up going up on one and down in another. Roll the dice. 5. All right, what are we allowed up here? We've got a dragon with strength of 7, so that's not going to happen. Let's go down here, flip an adventure card up. Bag of gold. I'm sure getting a lot of gold, which is okay for purchasing things. And so we'll grab that. Gives me 2 gold. Let's see what the minstrel does. 6. So, Hidden Valley, 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. He'll have to... So you battle the card. He's doing the storm first, which everybody missed the turn. Okay. Oh, and why didn't he have to battle that stuff? What the heck just happened? I don't know why he didn't have to encounter that stuff. Let's see. What did the storm do? Encountered event storm. I wonder what that actually did. I don't really know what the storm card. It went away too quick. Anyways, there's still 2 creatures there. So we can go head off to the woods to draw a card. Sure, let's go to the woods. Dragon. Oh, here we go. They don't really have anything to help me here, so I'll just encounter it. So I've got a 4 modifier with my axe versus a 7. I need a 6 big roll here, and he needs to roll like a really low number. Not going to happen. Now I can choose. No, rerolling wouldn't help. I don't think I can make him reroll. It'll only reroll me. And that's not going to help me. So I'm just going to continue and lose a life here. Again, you get your life back, so it's not a huge deal. Although you can only gain life back up to what you originally started with from healing and stuff. Let's see what he's going to do. He's probably going to come back down. Yep, he doesn't want to stay in that ring. It's too strong. Talisman is awesome. He flipped it. He's going to keep it, of course. You need a talisman to enter into this tower. The only way to get a talisman is to flip one open like he just did, or you can click this space here and do a quest for a talisman. When you complete the quest, you get a talisman. So I have to go here or flip a card like his. I'm not sure if there's more than one in a deck. So he grabbed that card, which is awesome for him. I can sell gold and buy spells, so totally want to do that at this point, because the spells can be pretty good. So let's travel to the spell shop. I will encounter that card. I will draw a spell. Random. So I can flip this, lose all strength, lose all craft, lose all gold. So if I get a 5 or 6, I'll get stuff, but otherwise I'll lose stuff. So I want to cast that on the opponent. And what else am I going to get here? Oh, I can't end my turn. I can just buy 1. You may only buy 1 spell per visit. That kind of sucks. Oh, let's cast it anyways and see what happens to him. So let's click on it. Random. I'll queue it. Queue it means it's just going to queue and it'll play it the next time it gives me a chance. There we are. So I will choose the minstrel to play it on. I will click continue. It's going to roll a dice, and hopefully it's a low number. And the minstrel can counterspell it. He's thinking, yep, he had a counterspell. So the minstrel had to flip the spell that counters my random card, so he didn't want to take the risk and decided to kill it, which is fine. Wastes his counterspell. Alrighty, I'm moving over to the guy that sells the spells. Does he have any money? No, he doesn't. Or he did, and he got it. It went quick. I couldn't see. Let's move back over here and try to grab that other... what's that? Draw a card? Maybe I should go that way. I don't need to go here at all. Become evil. Actually, this shouldn't be too bad. Gain a craft or gain a spell. Let's do that. Let's travel there. Hopefully we get a 5 or a 6 here. And I can use a reroll if I don't get what I want. 2, so ignored. I'm going to save my rerolls. I'm just going to continue on here. I could have rerolled and tried for it, but I find that you want to keep your reroll, your fates, just when you really need them. So, he's got a devil. If he's evil, gain a life. If he's good, I think he just lost a life. Yes, he did. Sweet. It was a good card for him or me. All right, let's get 1. Let's head up. Let's keep going up and try to get that last craft point adventure card. Place. Cave will remain here. Roll 1 dice and suffer the consequences. So let's roll a dice. 2. Attack by a goblin. Strength 2. We should be able to beat him, so we'll continue. Roll the dice. 4. Plus my modifier. 3. Plus his modifier. I beat him. The only sucky thing about beating the goblin is that I don't get the card because it's a... it's just an encounter card that sits there, so I can't trade it in for stuff, which kind of sucks, but it wasn't too bad to get through. Where's he going to move to? So he's moving to the Sentinel, but he doesn't have to cross the bridge, so he just draws a card there. There's a ghost going to inhabit an area here. 5 goes to the castle, so you'll see this ghost card fly to the castle area, which is right here, and when someone lands there, they have to fight the ghost. 3, perfect. Go back over here. I've gotten all of these crafts... here, so that's wicked. I'm going to leave the follower, and my craft's going to go to 7. Fabulous. There's the 2 paths you can go in this inner circle. If you go up, it's, I believe, a strength way, and if you go this way, the craft is a easier way. Lance, no evil character can have the lance. It adds 1 to strength, and it also adds lance. It adds 3 against dragons, so that's not too shabby. I rolled a 5. All right, we can hit the dragon. I do not want that, but I can attack the enemy here. So let's travel here, and I can steal something from him. So I can encounter the character, and I can beguile him, which is to steal his item, or I can do a physical combat on his craft, which would be 7 to 5. And our strength is similar, but he can probably use his guy to help him. What does he have for stuff? He's got that axe. He's got the talisman, so let's try to grab it from him. Roll the dice. What do I got to roll here to do this? 5. I think I needed a higher number. Let me see what I needed to do that. I needed a... He's a good character. A 6 to bejewel a good character. So I needed to roll a 6. Let's re-roll that. This is where one of those times where I got 2 fives. So I didn't get to steal his crap, but we'll try again next time. Excuse me there. All right, he's going to go to the city, and he's going to visit the mystic. Oh, yeah, sorry. He's going to roll what? He's going to become 4, become good. That's what he already is good, so it was a big waste of time for him. I'll come back up here and grab that last. So I'll head over this way and draw a card. I don't want to really visit that forest. Magic stream, 4 points of strength. Sweet. So now I'm going to grab my strength. It's going to go to 4. So definitely want to land on that a few more times. He's probably going to try to head over this way too. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. He can't hit it. He's going to probably come this way because he's going to go there next round. Heal lives. Okay, so evil, good characters can heal at the temple for free, so that's awesome for him. 4. It's the crags. Crags I roll. I need a 6, I'd gain a strength, or I'm going to lose a turn. The spirit with no problem. Maybe I should head that way and hope for a 6. I want to stay around this area. This area here, I don't really want to... Well, I could go over here and hope for... Yeah, let's do that. Let's travel and we'll roll, and hopefully for a 5 or a 6. Visit the Mystic. 5 or 6. 1. Become evil. I'm already evil. I don't really want to... I want to reroll it, but I'm not going to. Just because you want to save those rerolls for better things. And I don't get a 2. Good. What's he going to do? He's going to go draw a field. Guide. You do not need to roll the die in the chasm. So he took that follower. It just means when you land in this chasm, or I guess the chasm is up here, I think, it kills off your follower. And you hurt yourself too, so he doesn't have to roll when he gets there, which is a nice feature for himself. All right, 5. I can head back this way, or I can head back this way. What's this guy? A monster, strength of 5. I probably could kill him. And this way over here is the guy that sells me spells. Yes. Well, let's head that way because I need another spell. So let's travel to the spell merchant, encounter him, draw a card. Teleport. Cast on yourself instead of rolling the die. Teleport to any space in the same region. That's fabulous. Instead of rolling the die. So I need to roll a 1 to hit this one. I think what I'll do is roll the dice next round, and if I don't get a 1, I'll roll again with my fate. And he's visiting the city. No, he's going to become a toad. Come on, roll a 1. 3. Lose 1 craft. That sucks. He probably will reroll that. Oh, he lost a craft. I would reroll that for sure. So 5 takes me to the town, which I'm just going to reroll, try for a 1. 6. Well, what did I got here? I got to hit the cave, which is going to roll attack by stuff, or head up this direction to the fields, draw a card. All right, let's draw up there and grab a card. Pestilence. All the characters lose 1 life. All right, so we both are going to get hit with that. Mm-hmm. Me and him. Yep. And my turn. Did I grab a spell? Did I have... I thought I bought a spell. Teleport. I did buy a spell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to teleport next round, I think. I'm going to cue my spell here. Teleport. Click. Cue. Resume game. So next round it should use that. He's grabbing a shield. That's nice. Alright, so I'm teleporting. Here we go. Casting spell. He shouldn't have another counter spell. I think there's only 1, maybe 2. I don't know how many counter spells there are. Alright, I'm going to click on this to get my strength up again. Travel here. And I will encounter. And my strength went up to 5. Sweet. So I'm at 5 and 7. Definitely moving up in the world. I want to still land on this and grab the rest, and I wouldn't mind grabbing that as well. Oops. Excuse me. Gold for him. That's fine. I'm going to roll my dice. 1. Now, do I want to visit the dragon with a strength of 7, or do I want to buy a spell, which I have no money left, so I can't buy a spell? Dragon has a 7. I could get lucky on a roll. I do have the axe, which will give me a 6 strength versus the dragon, 7, so I might get lucky and roll it. Let's attack it. Worst case is I lose some life. Encounter. All right, so we'll roll a high number. 4, he needs to roll a 3, he needs to roll a little. Uh-oh. Okay, so I've got a 10. If I roll a 4, we tie. If I roll higher, I'm going to reroll for a high number, 2. It's even worse. Well, I'm going to take another hit here. Down to 2 life. Well, that's not so good. So I don't want him to roll a 3. Good. He can come visit me. No, he's going to head up that way. And I want to roll a 1 next round. Goblin of Strength should be easily to kill it. He's using his lance. So he's got a 4 plus 6. So he's easily beat the goblin. Killing off the goblin. Continue. Roll the dice. 2. The spell or the other one? Let's click on the other one. Draw a card. Oh, and I got a talisman. Sweet. For sure I want to take that. I didn't know there was more than one in the deck, which is great, because now he's got one and I have one. That's this card here. Yep. Good. So we don't have to do that quest in there. That's great. I do need some more health, though. Oh, he's ending his turn there. Two. The dragon, I believe. Or the cave. Could gain some good gold in there. Or attack a dragon or lose a turn. Let's try to fight the dragon again. I want to trade those cards in for... Roll the dice. Give me a 6. 5. That's not bad. Okay, low number here. 3. That's 10. Perfect. That is fabulous. So I will kick the dragon's butt. And, oh, trade trophies. So my 5 is going to go to 6. So I click on my enemy monster and my dragon. And I trade for strength. So 2 strength cards trade for strength. Perfect. So I'm at 6 strength now. And he's thinking what he wants to do. Sorcerer. He's going to buy another spell. Yep. My turn. 4. All right. I can head over to the cave, or I can head over to the spot where I can flip an adventure card. Book of Spells. You found a Book of Spells. You gain your full complement of spells according to current craft. So since my craft is 7, I should gain a bunch of spells here. Draw a spell. Boom. Immobility. Cast at the start of a character's turn before they moved. If cast on a character whose turn it is, they are immobilized, may do nothing. If cast on a creature, it cannot be attacked, but it may be evaded until the to the end of turn. Okay, and then I get healing. Oh, look at that. Up to my full life value. Fantastic. Preservation. Cast is followed on any character, follower, or enemy. It prevents a character from losing a life or a follower from being killed. When cast on enemy, it prevents it from being killed, and the attack is considered a standoff. On any character, follower, enemy, it prevents a character from losing a life. Well, that is great. So, I got 3 spells there. I think I'll cast the heal. Maybe I'll wait till I lose one more health and then cast the healing spell. There's cards that make you throw away all your cards and spells, so hopefully I won't draw that before using it. Oh, what's he doing? He's alchemizing his stuff. He's turning his items into gold. Did he just alchemize his talisman? He just threw away a talisman. I don't know why the computer plays poorly. He's going to land on me, and is he going to... when you land on a person, you can encounter the space or the character, but he took the space. And there's a healer there. The healer, he'll heals up to 2 lives for a character landing on it. Well, that's fabulous. So let's roll. I don't want to go to the crags. The chapel, I will lose a life. That wouldn't be so good. The crags, well, I can gain a strength, so I need to roll a 6 here. All right! Gain a strength of 1. 7. Fantastic. Couldn't have asked for a better roll there. We're actually getting quite high here. We can almost get through the sentinel soon. Or I guess I could land in a forest and build a raft. Goblins are easy to beat, so he should be able to kill this guy pretty easily. 5 to 7. No problem for him there. Alrighty. Yep. He killed him pretty good. Alright, I want to get down to this area still. 3. So this guy's the spell guy that sells me stuff, and that is a square. I'm going to go down here because I really want to get this. I don't want to encounter that. I got no gold anyways, so skip by it. I want to grab this extra strength down here. Where is he going to go? He's going to go to the forest or the woods. Oh, add 2 to your craft. That would have been sweet. Maybe I can steal it from him. Ooh, 5. I think I can steal it from him. So I'm going to travel there again, and I'm going to try to roll a 6 on him. Encounter character. Beule. 6. Come on, 6. 3. Let's reroll it. What? Oh, I didn't get a reroll? I have no fate left. Ah, that sucks. All right. Well, anyways, I guess so. I'm going to travel to head down to this graveyard, because graveyard, if I'm evil, I can replenish my fate. So, what's he doing now? He's using his raft. He's building a raft with his axe. That's what I should do, actually, too. I think I'm going to do that next round, actually. He's ditching cards. He has to throw away his lance because he doesn't have enough stuff. All right, so I'm in the forest as well, and I believe I have an axe. Yes, I do. So I can click this, and I can... No, I don't want to ditch cards. I want to use my axe. You may build a raft when you are in the woods or a forest. Maybe I have to land there and then build it when I'm there. I wonder. Is that even a woods or a forest? Where's the square? Yeah, it's woods. Interesting. So I guess I have to land there and choose to build it and then move on my next turn. So I guess I should have done that instead of the other one. Is this the healer? Oh, that's fabulous. Travel to the healer and gain back 2 of my life. Fantastic. Back up to full power. He is using his raft to cross the river. And he's on the Warlock Cave, so he's rolling a 5. He's took a quest. Or no, he rolled a 1. Take 1 life from another character. So he has to take a life from me to get the talisman, which he already had, and he threw away. So he played pretty stupidly. Let's go this direction. This will let me in striking range of all of those. Bag of gold, that sounds good. I can take that and buy another. I guess I can't buy a spell because I have 3. I should check my spells again and see what I've got here. A mobility cast at the start of a character's turn before they moved. They are immobilized. Well, that will maybe be good. I can immobilize the guy. Healing and preservation. So definitely can immobilize him. What's he going to do now? He's got to get out of there. The Oasis, draw 2 cards. An Evil Darkness. All characters except Throes of Evil must miss a turn, so that's good. He'll miss a turn, and I didn't see what else he left here. What was this other one? A wand. You may always have at least 1 spell if your craft allows. Well, that's a good card, but it's an object, and I don't think he can carry any more stuff. Let's roll it. 5. Does that get me? Yes, it gets me to grab that craft point, so let's grab those. I think that's the last one. I don't want to take the follower, so I'm going to leave the follower. And that should, yes, craft of 8. Wow, I'm doing really well. I think this is the best game I've ever played. We definitely have the highest numbers here. For sure. He's going to be drawing cards, though. Craft of 1. Oh, we should be able to beat this very easily. Yeah, he doesn't even have to roll. Now he can trade those in if he has enough of them. Let's see. He'll grab those 2 cards. And doesn't have enough to trade in. 2. Those are the woods. Forest, yes. So let's go to the forest and I'll build a raft. Roll my dice to see what I'm going to have. 3. I'll lose my turn. But I'm going to use this my axe. I should be able to click on the axe here. And why can't I use my axe? You may build a raft when you are in the woods or a forest. Huh. That is very odd. Well, I'm going to miss my turn, but I think he misses his turn too. I really don't know why I can't use my axe. He's using his axe. Okay, so he's building it on his turn. So I should be able to build it on my turn. Sorceress missed my turn. Yeah, is he going to cross the river? Interesting. So you can cross both ways. That's interesting. He's going to grab the follower. He grabbed the follower. And the shrine for gain a spell. He did gain one. Not sure what he grabbed, but that's okay. So now I should be able to use my axe. Yes, it's flashing. So, do I want to cross or do I want to grab this strength point? Magic stream. Oh, I definitely want to hit that stream. I'm going to roll the dice and head down and try to grab it. Oh, there we go. Got all my fate back. This was perfect. So because I'm evil, I can just replenish my fate. Back up to 3 fate. That lets me reroll. I want to get a 2 here. Oh, he's going to go... Let me flip the dragon. Oh, start of your turn, or we have just completed your move. The spell, remove any adventure card from the board. He's actually removing the dragon from the board. Interesting. All right, drawing a card for himself. Hermit. A stranger. Roll the die, and the hermit goes to the oasis. The first character there gets something. What does the first character get? First character to visit him there. A talisman. That's pretty sweet. I've never seen that card before. Okay, I'm on a two. Yes! Oh, this is wicked. So I'm going to head to eight now. Eight strength and eight craft. I am doing so well. I could probably even battle the sentinel instead of crossing here. Because I do have my axe, which gives me plus one. So I'm even with the sentinel right now. I think I might do that. Oh, he's going to materialize a ghost in the city. Okay, so let's see what I get here. Six. All right, so I can head over to here, which is the Warlock's Cave, which I don't need. All right, I can head over to here. Draw one card. Any creatures you fight, add two, which is fine, because I got pretty good strength. And I could go to this card here, which is the Holy Lance, which no evil character can have, or I can visit the woods. If I go to the woods, I might miss my turn, but I can cross the river on my next round. Or I could try to fight through the sentinel, so I'd roll a dice. I think what I'm going to do is head this way. So this should take me through the sentinel here. I'll have to battle. So I'm fighting the sentinel with a strength 9. I've got strength 9. I need a high roll here. 4 versus 5. Fantastic. Lost the sentinel. So I need basically a 6 to get by him, so I'm just going to continue. I don't know if I lose a health here. I don't. Yes, I do. That sucked. I probably should have just whipped around and went over across the forest, but that's okay. That's why it's a game. So he's praying at the temple to roll. He rolled a 4, which gives him nothing. All right, let's try this again. 4. All right, so I can land on the Portal of Power, draw one card. If you do not draw a card, if there's already one there, if you're crossing the plane of Portal, do not draw a card, then you must first use Craft to pick the Lock of Strength, okay? So I want to go there, I think. Got a chasm over here. I don't want to kill myself, so I'm just going to head over to this one. I'll go through the Sentinel again. All right, roll the dice. Give me a high number this time. Good. Now, as long as he doesn't get a 5 or a 6, perfect. I'll pass the Sentinel. That's good, so just continue. And I'll head through and head over to there, which I'll draw a card. Lion, strength 3. He's going to add 2, which is going to be a 5, but I've got an adding of a 9, I believe. So I should easily be able to beat the 9. The lion, the 9. That was funny. Even with a 1, 10 versus 5. So, 10 versus 5 plus 2. 10 versus 5. I'm not sure where my math is. But anyways, I beat the lion. I wonder if I can... I don't think I can trade. I need another one at least. Continue. End my turn. I might want to just go through here and try to win the game. I don't know. Let's read what it says for this getting through the Portal of Power. Choose an ability you are using. Okay, it says I must first use Craft to pick a lock of strength to force it. Choose which ability you are using to roll 2 dice. If the total is equal to or less than your chosen ability, move to the plane of peril. It is higher, remain here and lose 1 from that ability. That would suck. So I choose an ability and roll 2 dice, and I need to roll equal or less. So I roll 2 dice, I have an 8. So I need to roll less than... You must first use Craft to pick a lock of strength to force it. Choose which ability you are using. Roll 2 dice. If the total... Lock of Strength, or to force it. Instead, you must use Craft to pick the lock or Strength to force it. Okay, so you got to have a really high number in one of those numbers. Well, let's just roll the dice and maybe head around this inner ring for a while. Here, draw one card. Any creatures attack here, actually. 3 cards. What do we got to fight? Craft 2, easy. Strength 2, easy. Let's go down and kill these 2 creatures, and we will... grab their cards and increase my numbers. So we'll draw a 3rd card. Poltergeist. Ooh, that's not good. Poltergeists affect my movement to one space per turn, and I can only rid it by crossing the river by either bridge, raft, ferry, then you must discard it. One space per turn, though, is not horrible here, so we'll just continue and take them all. Take the follower. All right, so rolling the dice for killing the wolf. Easily kill the wolf. I think there was an auto-kill button there. I caught it. Could have used that. Continue. I probably should have used... I think I could have used the card. Couldn't I have used the spell to ditch that card? Preservation. Start a character's moved. Creature, no, I guess not. Dismiss. Sorceress wins, okay. And I'm going to auto-kill the shadow. Boom. Because he can't beat me. Continue. Now, can I use that to increase my craft? Yes, I can. So I click craft and craft. Trade for craft, but I got two there. No, I can't trade for strength. I think you need three the next time. So trade for craft. So my craft has went 9. That's good. And my turn. Now I've got that stupid poltergeist on me. So I can only move one round. Suffer one penalty. Either pay 1 gold or lose 1 life. I can do that. And this one heals, draw a card. I guess I could cross the river here. Oh, he's crossing the river, it looks like. He's going to use his... Oops, resume game. He's going to use his raft. Oh, he's discarding something because he built a raft. He's throwing away his lance. Righto. All right, so I'm going to head this way. Flip a card. Holy Grail. No evil character may have the Holy Grail. Okay, well, that's going to be dropped because I'm evil. And he can pick that up when he gets through. I'm going to go back here and draw 3 more cards next round. This is actually not so bad. No, he's using his raft to cross. He's going to head over to the cave again. Is he going to roll for a new quest? No, he did not. So I'll move back here and draw 3 cards. This is not so bad, actually, with that guy. So I got an enemy spirit, no problem to beat. An enchanter. See, the first able with a craft or 4 or more, he'll grant the following wishes. Perfect. And doppelganger, strength is ? Always has the same strength as your opponent, including any bonuses. If you kill it, gain 1 strength, but you must discard it instead of taking it as a trophy or remain here until killed. Interesting. So, let's encounter it. What do we got first? We got the doppelganger, strength 9. So I need to beat this guy, so roll a high number. Okay, roll less than 3. Oh, that's not good. Let's do a reroll. Let's reroll it. Get a high number. Oh, 1. Man, that sucked. All right, so am I going to lose a life for this? You lose. Yes, I know. And down to 2. Yes, I did. Okay, what? I just end my turn. Why can't I fight the other guys? That kind of sucked. Oh, well. I should have used my... Oh, I keep forgetting I have that card. I could have used my spell here. Prevents a character from losing a life when being killed. I could have done that. Healed up. That's what I want to do eventually on my next loss. I'm gonna immobilize. Let's immobilize the guy. Let's cue this spell and immobilize him next time. Okay. Select player. Yeah, immobilize the source. That's me. I don't want to immobilize myself. Oh, crap. Oh, dear. Now, what do I do? I don't know why I didn't let me select it. This is not fair. Immobilize. Cast at the start of a character's turn before they moved. If cast on a character whose turn it is, they are immobilized. Oh, it's my turn. Uncue, cue, uncue, dismiss. Uh-oh. Well, that was sucked on myself. Oh, that was not good. Well, casting immobility on myself. Well, you never know. Missing a turn might come in handy later. That was brutal. I wonder if it misses that turn at another one, or if it's just that one. I think it's just that one. Well, he's going to go to the cave and do nothing. Oh, I have 2 spells left to cast. Well, I really want to... Oh, no, I'm going to move back over to here and take my Holy Grail card and do nothing with it. It sounds like my sound is messed up. Or is it just playing a different song? Oh, he's grabbing my stuff. Oh, he's got to fight the doppelganger. Yes, roll a high number, doppelganger. Oh, come on. What a rip job that was. Well, he beat it, because it gets rid of it. Now he's got to fight the rest of the stuff and auto-kill everything. Yeah, that's great. Stealing all my stuff, although I could land on him next round. Oh, and he gets that too. That's fantastic. He's got a 9 craft as well. That's not good. What if I kill this guy? No, I can't kill him. Well, I could kill him with strength. Then just take off a health from him. But I want the spaces, so let's encounter the cards. A guide. I can't get him. Armor I can take, but I'd have to drop something. And I can't take the follower. Okay, so I wonder if I click take follower. Whoa, I took him. Interesting. I didn't think I could take another follower up with my guy. Take object? Well, sure, let's take it. And I don't want to take the mercenary. But I thought I have a poltergeist here. Where is my poltergeist? Yeah, I do. You must take as a follower. Oh, so I can have other followers. Although I thought my ability said I couldn't. Alright, well, he'll roll the dice and get out of the space. Rolling 2 dice in this square. In the temple. Oh, you can gain a talisman by rolling a 10 in the temple. Oh, he's doing something to me. Nullify. Cast any hero. The character must discard all his spells. Okay, wait, I want to try something. God, I can cast something here. Healing. Q. Can I heal myself? Is it going to let me heal? No. Oh, I lost my spells. Ah, oh, that sucked. And I have 2 health left. Well, head back to my Holy Grail. Nothing happens there for me. That's not good. I was hoping they could save that spell card for healing me up. I could probably go back to the healer and get 2 here. So if I roll a 2, I guess I can't roll a 2. I think I'm going to cross the river. No. Oh, dear. What's this? What's going on here? Okay, I want to cross. That should get rid of the poltergeist. Yes. And 4 strength posts are there. Yeah, I want that. Okay. 9 and 9. Sweet. Too bad I wouldn't have the poltergeist. I could roll 1, but... No, he's getting a sword. He's going to take it. I want to roll a 1 here. 5. So we can go over to this cave and roll for some, maybe getting some gold, or we can just head over here, or I can head, what's here, this a ghost? Ghost materializes, it haunts the area till it's killed. Craft of 4, it would be easy enough to grab. Let's try it. I gotta go through the sentinel again, so I'll roll my dice, 3, as long as it's lower than that, 2, perfect. That gets me through. It's kind of risky getting through there, and then I'll fight that ghost. Roll the dice. I should easily beat him. Oh, yes. Whoa, I was close. Although I guess it still was easily beat. 10 to 15. And do I get to claim that card? Yes, I do. Heal lives. What? Where did this come from? Why does it say heal lives? Royal Doctor. Heal up your life value, cost of 1 gold each. If you have a princess, heal 2 lives for free. Oh yeah, okay, well I'll heal 1. Can I do 2? No, just 1. Huh, I didn't even see that square. Actually, I guess I could have read that first before blindly flying into there. But it gives me 3 life, so that's okay. Ooh, a dragon. That's hard to kill. Oh, he doesn't have to encounter it though. He's got that ability against dragons. 6. We can head over to the ruins to draw a card. Or the desert. Lose a life and draw a card. Well, I don't want to do that, so we'll go over to the ruins. I can give my creature a +2. Mage. He will give 1 spell per visit if their craft allows it. Well, that's great. I will grab a spell, certainly. Hey, wait. Why didn't I get a spell? Maybe I have three spells? No. He will give one spell for each good character. Oh, he doesn't give me characters because I'm not good. I'm evil. All right, what are you going to do, Minstrel? Six. Take my Holy Grail. Yep. And he's got to drop something else, but the Holy Grail's not a bad card. Adds one to his craft. He's got 10 craft now. That's actually pretty decent. One. All right, I can head to the Cursed Glade. Strength and craft derived from objects and magics do not count as a space, nor you may use magic over. Okay, so that's not too bad. Chasm, that's not good at all. So let's head to the Cursed Glade, draw a card. Prince. Now, if I take the prince, I have to drop another follower, I believe, don't I? Did I just drop it? I thought one of my abilities was only I could only have one follower. You may take any one follower except... You may take him for except for Maiden, Unicorn, Princess from any character you land on. Oh, I can have more than one follower. It just says I can take one. Interesting. So what do I have for followers now? I've got a guide. Don't have to roll the dice in the Chasm, Crags, or Forest. And Prince, if I land on the castle, I can get healed for free. Which I still need, so that is good. Let's see if I can get down there, or over there. Three. I can head over to the Black Knight. That's not too good. I can head over to the Ruins, and that's fine. Let's travel to the Ruins. Hag. Oh, all other followers leave. I gotta visit the Mystic Village to get rid of the hag. Oh, it sucks. Yeah, laugh at me, you hag. That's not good. Hags, you lose all your followers and you gotta carry that hag. The only way you can get rid of a hag is going down to here. And getting rid of it. So that kind of sucks. Four. What do we got here? We got a maze. And we've got that sword. But neither of them I need. I'll go to just travel here and encounter the character. Let's actually beat him up a little bit. Let's encounter a character. I'm going to battle strength on him. I've got a much stronger strength than he does. Plus 10. 4 plus 10. That's 14. He can't beat me. Nice try, though. And continue. Now I can take an item from him. Ooh, add 2 to my craft. That'd be pretty sweet, actually. I think I want to steal that. Solomon's Crown. So 11, it also drops his craft. And I still can keep... Yes, I don't even have enough items yet. So I have 11 craft. I think I'm going to go for the end game here. I think I'm going to head up through here. And try to win. He's rolling a 3. Why do you roll a... I got to roll. Silly. 4. All right, what's this? Castle. Oh, is it? No, I don't have that. Do I have any gold? I have no gold. But I want to head and try to win the game here. So let's just go through. End my turn. It's a little hairy through here. In the mines, you got to roll 3 dice and subtract your craft from the total. That might teleport you somewhere. So we'll just see what happens here. And here you only move 1 square at a time. I should have my talisman still. Yes, I do. I made a mistake a few games ago where I went all the way through without a talisman and then I got there and couldn't do anything. It was very pathetic. 2. So that'll take me to the... Alright, so I got to get through the Portal of Power. So I want to use my craft to try to... And I want to roll a low number here. Oh my gosh! Can I reroll both dice? I can. I can reroll the 6. Man, I can't believe I rolled an 11. Do I have to tie it or get rid of it? True dice. It's equal or less. Move to the Plains of Peril. Okay, it's equal. It's 11. I got 11. So I'm good. I can just continue through. Perfect. Now, Plains of Peril. Stop here. Only move 1 space per turn. Got it. So next ones I gotta go to is this one. Plains of Peril. Don't do anything. Okay. So the next one I have to do in the mines, roll 3 dice, subtract my craft from the total and move directly to. So I got to roll 3 and subtract my craft. So I want 3 low numbers, I think. Uh-oh. What is he doing? Oh, he's doing something on him. I don't know what he did. Okay, so I'm going to head this way. So I have to roll 3 dice. I have to subtract my craft of 11, and I have to end up in the mines, which is this one, right? No. Yeah, that's what I can stay there. If I don't roll a high, if I roll, I need to roll a low number. I need to roll a low number. Okay, so I've got 8, 9, 10, 11 minus my craft is 0. So I should stay in the mines. Roll 3 dice, subtract your craft from the total, move directly to mines. So craft is 11, 8, 9, 10, 11, continue. Should be able to move. Why did it not move me to the... Oh, I'm in the mines, right. So next round is the Vampire Tower. I'll click resume game and I'll read this. Roll 1 die to determine how many lives the vampire takes. Oh, hold on a second. Oh, he's got a talisman, or he's doing something. I don't know what's going on anymore. Computer's freaking out, doing all sorts of stupid things. Oh, he's ditching cards. I think he left a talisman there. It wouldn't surprise me. Okay, Vampire Tower. Suffer blood loss. Roll 1 die to determine how many lives the vampire takes. You may discard any number of followers to avoid this loss of life. Each follower you discard prevents 1 loss of life. And how many followers do I have? I have... a hag. Follow us until you're by visiting the Mystic Village. You ignore you. Okay, so I'm pretty much screwed if I roll a high number here. So I've got to roll basically less than 2. 3. Uh-oh. No, not continue. Re-roll it. Low number. Oh, I'm toast. I'm dead. Oh, no. Oh, I can discard my follower. No way, can I? I would have lived. I'm still taking 3 lives. Wait. Why didn't it kill me? Why did I not die? Roll 1 die to determine how many lives the vampire takes. You may discard any number of followers to avoid this loss of life. Each follower discard prevents 1 loss of life. Oh, 1 or 2 lost 1. Oh, I see. So I lost... And, oh, wow, that's great. So it should be able to get to this next spot and win the game, I hope. He's drawing a spell. He probably can still do something to me. Fight the pit fiends. Roll 1 die and fight that many pit fiends with strength 4 each, 1 by 1 until you lose or defeat all pit fiends. You may then move on until after they are defeated. Okay, well, can I go to this tower instead? Apparently not. All right, I want to roll a low number here. Seriously. Well, I got to fight them with strength of 4 each, 1 by 1. So I have a 9 strength. So I should be able to beat every one of them. 9, I have 1 reroll. If I have 9, they have 4. That's 5 more. I should be able to beat every one of those. Yeah, like a 10 to 4? Seriously? There, that's 1. 10? Yeah, like I'm going to win every round. I don't think they can even... I can't do anything here. I've got plus 10 to my strength here. I actually am very lucky because I could auto-kill all these guys. I think I'll just auto-kill everything. Because I managed to make both my numbers go up quite high at the same time. I'm going to auto-kill this time. Continue, auto-kill, continue, auto-kill, continue. Okay, I should be there. I should be at this command, whatever you want to call it. And from there, I'll be able to just wipe the other guy out here, I believe. I've never actually done this yet. This is my first game that I'm going to win. What is this? What? I'm still not there? You must have a talisman to enter. You can only enter if you have a talisman. I do have a talisman, so let's travel there. Seriously, it's taking a long time to get there. But this is great. My first game potentially of winning here, Bandit. Well, he's got to fight him, but 4 versus 4. Oh, he bribed him, so he didn't have to fight him. Okay, look at that. Crown of Command, travel here. Cast the Command spell. Every character except the one who possesses the Crown of Command must lose a life. Fantastic, so he should be down to 3. Oh, I have to roll a dice. Why do I have to roll a dice? If this 4, 5, or 6, all characters lose 1 life. So I need a 4, 5, or 6. All right, so I need a 4, 5, 6. Here we go. 4, perfect. Continue. Down to 3 for that guy. So this is how you win the game. I just have to cast this 3 times before he gets there or gets me off of this spot, and I will win this game. So I don't know if he has any hope. So I should be able to just cast the command spell over and over again. I have one fate, so I'll save that to when he's got 2 life or 1 life. Roll the dice. 5, that's good. So that takes him down to 2. He could heal if he's lucky. He can heal up here. He's missing a turn. All right, that sounds awesome. Command spell. Obviously, he doesn't have any way of counterspelling it. Oh, he does have something. He's casting on himself a spell. Healing. Back up to their face value. He should have waited till the next round, because he's going to go to 4 life or whatever he started with. And I have to roll to hit him down again. 1, so that did nothing. All right, well, hopefully he doesn't have any more of those. Sometimes it's a slow grind, apparently, to killing off guys. Yeah, you can have the bag of gold. That's fine by me. That won't help you that much, I don't think. Although you could probably buy spells with it. I'll cast the command spell again. See if he does any. Roll the dice. 1. That's fantastic. It's going to be a while at the crown of command. Oh, he's buying more spells. Great. As long as he can't teleport me off of the spot I'm on, that would be the best for him to do, to take me off. Oh, what is with me rolling all these ones? Ah, he can go anywhere he wants. Or he can travel to a different destructions. Yeah, removing a venture card from the game. He's getting rid of the marsh. Again, I'm not sure why he... Maybe he wanted to get rid of his spell. I guess that's probably what he wanted to do. Orb of Knowledge, that's a good one. Mule's also really good. Lets you carry stuff. And the Mercenary, well, he's going to take everything. He spent his gold, so that's fine. And now he's got to drop stuff. He's going to take the... Well, he's in a good shape, but if I wasn't casting command spells every round... All right, let's see if I can get a high number this time. One again. Imagine that. Oh, he's got to fight an ape. You should be able to beat him fairly easily. Oh, he trained it. Made it his follower. All right, high number this time. Are you serious? How many ones can I roll in a row? This is ridiculous. Watch, he'll roll a high number. 3. If I can roll another 1, that's going to be like, ugh. Oh, he's taking stuff, leaving stuff. It's just got to be a matter of time before I start rolling higher numbers. There we are. Now, as long as he doesn't visit the healer and heal up tons, and I can get him down. 4, lose a follower. 7, gain a craft. Alright. Come on, another big number. Although he just rolled a 4, so he'll probably roll a 1 again. Alright. He's down to 2. So, Very good. Okay, I think he can heal up on this doctor. Yeah, he needs to. Oh, he has no gold, though, so. Oh, that's good that he has no gold, because he could. Oh, he might have a prince, though. Are you serious? Oh, good. All right, if he had a prince or something, he could get. Oh, he did. He just restored his health. Oh, how many times can he use that prince? Is it, like, unlimited? And back to the ones. This is fantastic. Holy crow, he's got a lot of stuff. Oh. Oh, a market's been set up. And he gains a gold. Oh, he's discarding it, though. Using his art of not. What's he going to ditch? The market? Yep. Ring. Add one to your strength and one to your craft. He took that. He's got that mule, so he can really take a lot of stuff. This is the... he's gotten pretty lucky. Big number. 2, of course. It's not good that he can keep on healing up with his prince or princess, so he's just going to keep landing on that. Oh, he re-rolled the dice. He didn't want to play anything. You have been encountered by a metaforces on a mission. If you are evil, gain one craft. I'm not sure what else happened, if anything. We will cast the command spell again for like the 19th time. Course, I do nothing. It's gonna suck if he ends up coming in here and kicking my butt. He's re-rolling. What does he want to do? Oh, get a follower, get me killed. There we are. Oh, he chose not to roll it. I guess he's got a follower that prevents that from happening. One again. Wow, I have rolled so many ones with this command spell. He's got no fate left, so he's got to do whatever he needs. 9. Gain one spell. Of course he does. Six, there we are. That hits him. Down to 3 for ya. And 6, where's he gonna go? Oh, he's gonna flip over some cards. Demon, craft 10, that's a good one for him to try to beat. Oh, Orb of Knowledge, what's he gonna get rid of? The demon, doesn't want to fight the demon. Each character's spells are discarded. Whoa. Oh, and draws another one somehow. I'm not sure what's going on, actually. But let's see if I can hit him another health. You can slow down the computer's speed so that you can... Oh, temporal wave. You may take 3 turns before the play passes. Oh, this is fantastic. I don't know if I'm going to ever kill this guy. I should be beating him, but him not. There's a spell for you, sure. I should speed up the computer's EI. I think I might. Let's see if I can. All right, roll the dice. 7. Gain a craft. 11 craft. He should really be coming in here and trying to beat me. He's targeting me with something. Oh, lose all craft, lose all gold, lose all strength, gain all life. This is not good. I wonder if I have anything that can help me here. I have nothing that can help me. Well, losing all strength, losing all craft, losing all gold. Let's see, I can gain a strength. Let's get a high number here. 1, become a toad for 3 rounds. I do not want to be a toad for 3 rounds. I wonder if I can still cast the command spell. Let's just become a toad. Oh, draw a card. Oh, that's him. I think go see what a toad does. All objects go far left in the space, you turn into a toad. You cannot pick any object far as a goal while a toad. Move one space per turn, no die roll. Retain all character lives, retain your fate. You cannot cast spells, but you may keep the ones you had. When returning, normal is for minus all objects and fate. Lovely. So I dropped all my stuff. And I'm just going to miss a bunch of my turns here. Do I have a talisman still? I don't even have a talisman anymore. Not good. Well, we're just going to continue on here until we either lose the game or win the game. I wonder if he used teleport when he was in this inner ring, if he could just teleport right around through everything. Oh, he's going to heal up again. Fantastic. What does skip encounters mean? Oh. Yeah, I get all that stuff again. Maybe I'll get to pick up all my stuff as soon as I rematerialize. Oops. All right, you rolled a 1, which means maybe on my next round I might be able to roll a higher number than a 1. Well, there's my 6 that I probably would have rolled, and there's a 5 the bear rolls, which means I'm going to roll a low number next time. Oh, he's trading trophies in. This is not fun. I thought I could win the game quickly by going here, and I'm just dragging it on and on and on. And he's rolling high numbers, and I'm rolling low numbers. He's going to have a... bribe that guy. I don't know why he wastes his gold. Well, this should be the last turn of my toad. Yes, I'm back to normal. 6. Rolling 2 dice. 5. Enslaved. Stay here until you roll a 4, 5, 6 for your moved. Alright. Continue. So I get to get my stuff back. Yes, I do. Take object. Take objects. Take object. Take objects. Cast command spell. Well, that's good. I got my stuff back. I'm happy about that. Now, if he can roll no low numbers and I can roll high numbers, I'll weasel him down. Let's see what he rolls. Frick! I should have used my reroll. I probably would have rolled that 5. Seriously, how many times can I cast this command spell? And since he rolled a 5, I can probably pretty much guess I'm going to roll a 2. Of course. So much fun. 6. Dragon. Well, you should be able to beat him. 8. Oh, maybe not. Come on, high number. Yes. Okay, that'll lose a health. Thank you, dragon. Ah, shield. Oh, he rolled a 5, which means he wasn't taking any damage. Which means the dragon beat him, but he doesn't lose any health. Which means I am sitting here casting this command spell on end, on end. There we go. Down to 3 again. Oh, back up to the healer. Full health for him. Unbelievable. This is truly the game that never ends. And of course I roll a 2. He needs to come in here so I can just concentrate on kicking his butt. I think I'm going to increase the speed of the computer. Let's see. Music volume, advanced options, AI speed. How far can I go? 11. There we go. Now it should just flash, and it should be like tons of crazy things happening, but this might speed us up to get where we want to go here. Apparently this is still quite slow, but... Two, of course. How many twos can I roll in one game? Oh, he got a one. Bandit. This is going to be hard to follow along, but... Essentially, he's increasing his stats while I'm sitting here casting the command spell, trying to kill him. Meanwhile, he just keeps on healing. There, finally a high number. Now, I just don't want him to roll into that castle. That probably gets him there. Yep. He needs to come into the center area so I can... Just keep casting command spell after command spell. Now there's another six. Six for him. All right, he's at three. Let's get him to two here. I'm gonna roll a four. A one. Oh, he's back on the health. Seriously, this is seriously stupid. At this point, if you're still listening to this YouTube channel, I have to give you extreme credit because I would have ditched this video long ago. I'll see if he can... All right, give him a high number, Dragon. Yeah, nice. 12? Shield talk. Oh, seriously, he could be getting hit with these numbers. He just keeps on going and going and going. Those followers are really helping him. He needs to get a card that, there we go, that kills off his followers. Eventually, he'll probably hit something. Pay one gold to lose a life? Seriously? All right. I don't know why the computer plays stupid sometimes. Give me a high number. He'll be down to one life. Come on. Seriously, a one. All right. Gnome. He's got like a record amount of people here. This is kind of unfair, I think. Give me a high number, and he'll be down to one. Here, roll a five. Oh, yes! All right, he's down to one health. This could be the closest I've come to winning this game. He's using a raft, fine by me. I think he's going to lose his turn here, which means I may have just won the game. All right, this could be it. This is where I'm going to use my last fate. If I don't roll a high number, I have... There we go. Six. Continue. Takes him to zero. And winner, player one. Yay. First game won. First game played through. Very, very awesome. And that's how you play Talisman. Spirit Destroyer. You killed the most spirits. You won the most battles. You lost the Poltergeist. You had the highest strength. You had the highest craft. You traded the most trophies. You won the most fights against characters. You spent the most gold. Gee, what didn't I do? And I won the game. Congratulations, you have gained a level. Select one Runestone card to keep. Interesting. Health, bronze, a long and prospective life, plus one to your starting lives. Alertness, you'll never miss a turn when you roll one at the tavern. Resistance, your toad resistant grows, you're only a toad for two turns. Well, I definitely think the health runestone is the best one. So I wonder how I play with that, or if it just automatically plays with it. Huh. Sorceress. Maybe that's on the dismiss. That's on my profile for the Sorceress. Let's see if I click play and click new game and choose the Sorceress. That's not the Sorceress. There she is. I wonder if that that rune starts me with any of my characters. But anyways, that's the playthrough. Thanks for watching. Again, if you made it through that grueling battle of me casting and constantly getting twos and ones and getting through, I much appreciate you. Thank you for watching again. And that is the playthrough of Talisman Digital Edition for the Android. And you guys have an awesome day, and we'll see you in the next video.